subscribe to our channel and press the bell button for latest educational videos.
Hello aspirants, welcome to Classic Education's YouTube channel. I am Gautam Prabhudev Bhamanpad, faculty for geography in Classic KS IS Study Circle Dharwad. Today we are learning about ocean currents. First of all, before we directly jump into ocean currents, we should able to know some basic facts behind ocean currents, like pressure systems, winds, and Coriolis force. We should be able to know pressure systems, winds, and Coriolis force. First of all, we will learn about pressure systems. Consider we have got two surfaces like this. We have got two surfaces, surface one, surface second. In the surface one, for example, this is under the influence of night. What does that mean? We will get all the dust particles, water particles, and all other particles. We'll find them very near to the surface. What does that mean? These particles have mass for themselves, hence they will pressurize vertically downwards like this. At the other surface, we are seeing very less particles. What does this mean? When do we see very less particles on the surface? Whenever we get sun, because of the sunlight, all the particles gets dispersed away. They will spread out. Hence, we are seeing very less particles over the surface. Hence, very less pressure when compared to the surface first. Hence, we called this surface is under high pressure. And we called this surface is under low pressure. Try to understand. This particular surface is filled up by so many water particles, dust particles. These water particles, after completely filled up, they want to move away from that. What does that mean? They are moving towards empty space. Hence, these particles are moving from high pressure to low pressure. And this is what we call it as wind. Wind blows from high pressure to low pressure. Hence, the first concept was about pressure systems. We could able to know what is pressure system and how, in which direction the wind is blowing, that is high pressure to low pressure. Here we have got the concept of winds. What does it say? Wind is the flow of gases on a large scale on the surface of the earth. Wind consists of gases, dust particles, water particles, etc. Here, what does this mean? We have learnt about pressure systems. Whenever we got sunlight, it was under low pressure. What does that mean? High insulation indicates low pressure. Insulation in the sense, energy that we get from sun. Energy that we get sun. Low insulation in the sense, very high pressure. This happens during night, low insulation. Hence, we have derived the wind blows from high pressure to low pressure. This is about the first concept. What is the second concept we have? We have got Coriolis force. Coriolis force. What does it say? And it is an apparent force that arises because of the Earth's spin or rotation around its axis. Freely moving objects are deflected to the right side of the direction of the motion in the northern hemisphere and to the left of the direction of motion in the southern hemisphere. What does this mean? For example, let's consider this is our northern hemisphere. This is North Pole and this is equator. We are taking two reference latitudes like this. This is latitude 70 degree north. This is latitude 20 degree north. Okay. I am considering two points. One is A, another is B. I have taken two points. I am considering point A as my source and point B as my target. For example, just try to calculate the distance in between A to B. It is around 50 into 111 kilometers. Why is it so? Because the distance in between two consecutive latitudes is 111 kilometers. And 70 minus 20, it is 50 latitudes into 111 kilometers. Hence, we have got 5,550 kilometer distance. We have got in between point A and point B. For example, A is throwing a ball in air towards B. What's the target? The target is B. The source is A. The ball wants to travel in air. It is traveling around 5,550 kilometers in air. What does that mean? The ball travels 5,550 kilometers. It has to take lots of time to travel this much distance. Lots of time. Remember, the Earth rotates from west to east. What does this mean? By the time the ball travels towards B, the B would have moved towards east like this, because the Earth rotates from west to east. The actual direction is this, but the ball is traveling towards earlier point. But the actual target is already moved towards east. Hence, check the direction from A. We have got origin A. From there, we have to check the direction. If it is direction, the target is towards B, the ball is moving towards right side of the motion. If it has to travel like this, it is traveling towards right side like this. It is deflecting towards right side. Where is it? It is in the northern hemisphere. Hence, we conclude. In the northern hemisphere, see, the objects are deflected to the right side of the direction of the motion in the northern hemisphere. Similarly, in the southern hemisphere, the deflection is towards left side. Hence, we conclude in the northern hemisphere, the Coriolis force deflects towards right side, and the Coriolis force in the southern hemisphere deflects towards left side. The next concept we have is global or planetary events. What does this mean? Try to understand. We have got two globes. I'm just mentioning the latitudes we have. This is equator. This is 30 degree north. This is 60 degree. This is North Pole. Similarly, this is our South Pole. This is 60 degree. This is 30 degree. South, south, north. Is it clear? Now, try to understand, where do we get highest insolation at? It is exactly at equator. Hence, can we consider, as the insolation is very high, can we consider this particular latitude or the belt is under low pressure? Yes, we have already studied it. Where is it? Just check. High insolation, low pressure. Low insolation, high pressure. Now, see, we have got low pressure here. Okay, one more concept. Just check. If you are saying a place is under low pressure, what does that mean? It is surrounded by high pressure. Like this. It might be surrounded by high pressure. Only then we can conclude to this. The center point is under low pressure. What does this mean? Just check here. We have got low pressure. What does that mean? In the surrounding of it, we have got high pressure. high pressure in the sense at 30 degree north and south, we are getting high pressure belts. Okay, what about at poles? We don't have any insulation, hence it is under the influence of high pressure. High pressure. Okay, in between these two high pressures, we have a low pressure belt here. Now, we have already understood the direction of the winds. It is from high pressure to low pressure. What does this mean? The high pressure belt is here at 30 degree north and 30 degree south. From there, the wind is blowing towards equator. Why? Because equator is under low pressure belt. Now, this is high pressure, this is low pressure. Now, we have filled up all the directions of winds that we observe on the globe. It is like this. But we have done a massive mistake. What is that? We have not applied Coriolis force at all. What does that mean? If the wind is straight like this, it has to deflect towards right side in the northern hemisphere. It has to deflect towards left side in the southern hemisphere. What does that mean? From here, the wind should blow like this. And from here, the wind should blow like this. Okay, just analyze the direction of all the winds. These winds, we usually call it as trade winds. These are our westerlies. These are our westerlies. These are our easterly winds. Easterly winds. That's it. That's it. We could be able to know the directions of all the planetary winds, all the permanent winds. Okay. The next thing we have is ocean currents. How are we linking all these concepts with ocean currents? That we are going to do now. Now, try to understand, this is our equator, okay, this is our equator. Now, this is our 30 degree, and this is our 30 degree, like this. Now, from 30 degree north to 30 degree south, we have got trade winds, which are blowing like this. Concentrate. Try to concentrate. What is this ocean? This ocean is North Atlantic Ocean and South Atlantic Ocean. Together, we have got Atlantic Ocean. In the Atlantic Ocean, the trade winds are blowing from east to west in this direction. Hence, just check, aren't these winds influencing the water to move from east to west? Yes, they are influencing water to move from east to west. Hence, just check, the water started moving like this. The water started moving like this. Okay, now try to understand these water currents. First of all, what is current? What is current? Current is nothing but continuous flow of something. Here, if it is continuous flow of electron, then it is electric current. If it is continuous flow of water, then it is water current. If it is continuous flow of water in the ocean, then it is ocean current. What is this? This is the ocean current. We are directly naming them now. What are we doing? We are naming them. Try to understand. This is in North Atlantic Ocean. We are trying to name this ocean current. This is North Atlantic Equatorial Current. Is it at equator? Yes, it is at equator. Hence, I am just calling them North Atlantic Equatorial Current, which are moving from east to west. What about this? We are calling this as South Atlantic Equatorial Current. Now try to understand, soon after they go and collide with South America, we have got Brazil here. Brazil, right? Brazil. This particular ocean current, which one? South Atlantic Equatorial Current, is going and colliding with Brazil coast. After it collides with Brazil coast, will that get deflected like this? Yes, the landform is like that. Because of that, the ocean current is getting deflected towards this, towards southern pole. As this particular ocean current is moving over Brazilian coast, we called this ocean current as Brazilian current. Brazilian current. Try to understand. After hitting, we have got Antarctic in the southern pole. After hitting Antarctic, they will start moving like this continuously. Where is moving? Isn't it entering Indian Ocean also? And isn't it entering Pacific Ocean also? Hence, this particular current at southern pole is continuous and circulating throughout the globe. Hence, we called this very current as Antarctic Circumpolar Current or West Wind Drift. That's it. This current is also called as West Wind Drift or Antarctic Circumpolar Current. Now, try to understand, this West Wind Drift is moving in branches like this. When it is moving in branches, the uppermost branch of West Wind Drift collides or hits the southern tip of Africa and gets deflected towards equator like this. Try to understand. We have got a country called as Angolo here. Angolo. In that, we have got very famous port called as Benguela. In Angolo, we have got very famous port called as Benguela. On that particular name, we have named this current, saying Benguela current. These are the currents that are present in South Atlantic Ocean. Similarly, we are going to look at North Atlantic Ocean. Try to understand. We have got Caribbean islands here. When this North Atlantic Equatorial Current moves over Caribbean islands, this particular current we called it as Caribbean current. Try to understand. This is Gulf of Mexico and this is our Florida. When one of the branch of this Caribbean current enters Gulf of Mexico and blows or moves over Florida coast, we called that current as Florida current. What is that current? We called that as Florida current. Soon after that, this particular current continues to flow towards northwards. In the sense, they are going towards Canada. Try to understand, as they are going towards Canada and they have crossed Gulf, we called this particular current as Gulf Stream. We called it as Gulf Stream. Try to understand, we have got Arctic Ocean here. Arctic Ocean. From the Arctic Ocean, we are getting one more current called as Labrador current. This Labrador current mixes up with Gulf Stream to become North Atlantic Drift. North Atlantic Drift. This North Atlantic Drift moves towards Scandinavian countries. We have got Sweden, Finland, and Norway. We have got Sweden, Finland and Norway. As this particular current is moving over the coast of Norway, we called this current as Norwegian current. Try to understand. We have got, see, one of the branch of North Atlantic Drift goes and heads Britain or Ireland, and gets deflected towards equator like this. We have got so many islands here. In the west of Africa, we have got Canary Islands. What are those islands? We have got Canary Islands. Here we have got Canary Islands. Hence, the ocean current which moves or blows over those islands, we call that ocean current as Canary Ocean Current. Canary Current. After that, we have got a country called as Guinea here, Ivory here, Ghana, Benin, and almost all the countries. Try to understand. Here we have got Guinea. When this particular current moves over the coast of Guinea, we called that current as Guinea current. And the cycle continues. This particular thing, we have done it in whole Atlantic Ocean like this. Okay, one more thing we have missed. See, one of the branch of West Wind Drift, after hitting Falkland, it will move towards equator like this. We called that current as Falkland current. This is about ocean currents that we have in Atlantic Ocean. Next thing, we have got Pacific Ocean. Try to understand. This is our equator. Equator, the trade winds are blowing. Similarly, the same concept again. See, the ocean current is moving like this. Again, one more current is moving like this in the southern Pacific Ocean. We called this particular ocean current as North Pacific Equatorial Current. This current as South Pacific Equatorial Current. Very simple. After that, just check. It is hitting Papua New Guinea, Indonesian islands, and all those islands to get deviated towards southern pole like this. Where is it moving? We have got East Australia. See, it is towards East Australia. Hence, we called this current as East Australian current. Simple. After that, it is joining our West Wind Drift like this. What is this? West Wind Drift. After that, one of the branch of West Wind Drift is hitting the southern tip of South America to get deflected towards equator like this. And we are calling that current as Peru-Chile current. We have got Peru here, we have got Chile here. On those countries' names, we are calling those currents as Peru-Chile current or Humboldt current. This, the ocean currents we have done in South Pacific Ocean. After that, we are doing it in North Pacific Ocean now. Try to understand. We have got Philippines Islands here. When the ocean current, North Pacific Equatorial Current, moves over the course of Philippines Islands, this ocean current, we called it as Philippines Current. Soon after, that blows over Japan. We called that current as Kuroshio current. You can just check the slang of that language. Kuroshio. It is a kind of Chinese slang or Japanese slang. Hence, we called it as Kuroshio current. After that, one of the ocean current that is blowing from polar side towards this, like this, in this direction. What is this sea? In the north of Japan, we have got Okhotsk Sea. What is that? Okhotsk Sea. From there, we are getting one more current called as Oyoshio current. What is that current? Oyoshio current. After that, they both will mix and travel like this. We have got Alaska here. The USS part, Alaska. We have got Alaska. Here, when it moves like this, This current we called it as Alaska current. Soon after, it travels over the coast of California. We have got California here, California. Soon after it travels over the coast of California, we called this current as California current. And the cycle continues. These are the ocean currents that we have in Pacific Ocean. The next thing, we have got Indian Ocean. Okay, this is the equator. This is the equator. Similarly, again the same concepts, trade winds are blowing from east to west. They are influencing the water to move like this. That's it. What is this current? This time, this is our North Indian Ocean current, equatorial current. What about this? South Indian Ocean equatorial current. Very simple. Now try to understand. This South Indian Ocean equatorial current is hitting Somalia, Kenya and getting deviated towards southern pole like this. Are you able to understand? Now, see, this is our Mozambique channel, which divides Madagascar and mainland Africa. Hence, we called it as Mozambique current. Mozambique ocean current. Soon after that, you can observe here. See, we have got Cape of Good Hope at the southern tip of South Africa. Dead beside that, west to east, we have got Cape Agulhas. What is that? Cape Agulhas. Now, as this ocean current is moving over the coast of Cape Agulhas, we called this particular current as Agulhas current. Agulhas current. After this, it is joining with west wind drift like this and circumferencing all over the globe. Now, try to understand. The uppermost branch of this west wind drift hits the southern tip of Australia and gets deflected towards equator like this. What is this current? The current which was there in the east side of Australia, we called it as East Australian current. This is at the west side of Australia. We called this current as West Australian current. Very simple. This is about Southern Indian Ocean currents. Now, try to understand, we no need to concentrate more on directions of these ocean currents because, just check, it might be like this or it might be like this. This particular current we called it as Arabian Sea current. And what about this? This is our Bay of Bengal current. Very simple, right? We have done all the ocean currents of all the oceans. Now, we'll club all together, okay? We'll try to club all of them. This is our equator. Now, this is our Atlantic Ocean. Here we got North Atlantic Equatorial Current, South Atlantic Equatorial Current. North Atlantic Equatorial Current, South Atlantic Equatorial Current. Try to understand. After hitting Brazil, it is becoming Brazilian current. Brazilian current. After that, the current continues to flow all over the globe. It is our Antarctic Circumpolar Current. Antarctic Circumpolar Current or West Wind Drift. One of the branches of this Antarctic Circumpolar Current is hitting the southern tip of South Africa and getting deviated towards equator. And this current we called it as Benguela current. Why is it so? Because we have got a very famous port in Angola called as Benguela. Hence we called it as Benguela current. After that, soon after this North Atlantic equatorial currents move over Caribbean islands. We call that as Caribbean current. Here we have got one more current. We call that as Florida current, as we have Florida here. Florida. After that, we have got one more current here. We called it as Gulf Stream. Gulf Stream. Gulf Stream. Soon after it crosses Gulf of Mexico, we called it as Gulf Stream. One of the current comes from polar region. We called it as Labrador current. They both will mix, travel towards north side, northern pole like this. We call this as North Atlantic Drift. After that, the current moves towards Scandinavian countries. We call that as Norwegian Current. One of the branch of North Atlantic Drift hits Ireland and Britain and gets deviated towards equator like this. Here, this current we called it as Canary Current, and here we called that current as Guinea Current. Is it? Now, come to Indian Ocean. Here we called it as South Indian Ocean Equatorial Current. North Indian Ocean Equatorial Current. Here we have Arabian Sea Current. Here we have Bay of Bengal Current. Is it? After that, we have got Mozambique Current. We have got Agulhas Current. And this Agulhas Current is joining with West Wind Drift. West Wind Drift. One of the branch of West Wind Drift is hitting the southern tip of Australia and moving towards equator. We call it as West Australian Current. Very simple. After that, here we have South Pacific Equatorial Current, North Pacific Equatorial Current. Now, as it is hitting Papua New Guinea, Indonesian Islands, and deviating towards southern side like this, we call this current as East Australian Current. As this North Pacific Equatorial Current is blowing over Philippines, we called it as Philippines Current. After that, Japan, we called it as Kuroshio Current. After that, from the upside, we have got one more current. We call that as Oyoshio Current. Oyoshio Current. After that, it is moving towards Alaska. It is moving towards Alaska. We called this current as Alaska Current. After that, we have got California. We have got Californian Current. And cycle continues. Now, this is West Wind Drift. One of the branch hits southern tip of South America and becomes Peru-Chile Current or Humboldt Current. This is about ocean currents all over the oceans. All the concepts like why some currents are called as warm currents, some currents are called as cold currents, and about fishing zones, how are they forming, and what about desert formation. All these are interlinked with ocean currents. We'll come up with all these concepts in the coming session. Thank you.
Please subscribe to our channel and press the bell button for latest educational videos.